Heaven Official's Blessing, Chapter 56. Audio source, wuxiaworldaudiobook.com. In Search of the Past, Retracing Steps to Mao Taiking. Without knowing why, Xie Lian was suddenly filled with courage again. After Lang Qianchu had left, Xie Lian's steps had been hesitant, his shoulders slumped. But this courage came from nowhere, and who knows where it will be directed to, only that it had made him stand tall once more. He stood unmoving, and Xi Qingxian approached, giving him a small pat on the back. "What a guy, Your Highness. I don't know how you managed to befriend him, but you're very lucky." This was the first time Xie Lian had heard someone tell him he was lucky. He glanced at Xi Qingquan and smiled. "Really? Maybe. I think so too." Behind them, Feng Xin continued to wipe his face. When the two turned their heads around, they saw his face covered in white strands, miserable and unkempt, and laughed. "Sorry about that," Xie Lian said. That counted as an apology on Hua Cheng's behalf. Feng Xin finally picked off all the white strands from his face. "I'm not as skilled, so I can't say anything." The three of them then conducted a final search of all the caves, double-checking to make sure there were indeed no more humans or anything else left behind, before riding a draft of wind back to the heavenly court. Once they passed the gates, they saw the streets were filled with crowds of junior officials from the middle court, moving about, checking every nook and cranny of every palace as if they were about to face a grave enemy. When they finally arrived at the Great Martial Hall, the audience chamber was already filled with heavenly officials of the upper court, and even from afar they could hear them arguing. The first thing they heard was, "Hua Cheng dare accuse the upper court heavens of sending a spy, how ludicrous. Why would the heavens need to send a spy?" Xie Lian and Xi Qingxian lightly cleared their throats when they heard. Sending a spy was most likely the truth. Nothing had been settled yet and the officials already couldn't wait to start blathering. If the deed was true, then wouldn't it be a slap in their own faces? The three entered the hall with Xi Qingxian in the lead. When the crowd saw him, they greeted, "The Lord Windmaster has returned. Thanks for your hard work." But all eyes were on Xie Lian. They were about to press for more but saw emerging from behind a Feng Xin that looked like he crawled out of a bloody pond, his face dark. Everyone was frozen to their spot and immediately turned their eyes away. After all, no one wanted to be cussed loudly in the Great Hall. Only Mu Qing, who not only didn't care to avoid him, he even purposely stared, his intent more than obvious. Xie Lian raised his gaze and saw Jun Wu was seated above in his throne, a hand supporting his head, fingers pressed against his temple, his eyes closed, looking exhausted. Xie Lian could understand exactly how he felt. In the past, there might not even be conferences and meetings of this sort for months. But with all the incidents that had happened recently, the Great Martial Hall was filled to the brim time and time again, as if there is a situation every day and everyone was hoping they'd meet even twice a day. Besides, there were many that wanted to have their voices heard, yet they're nothing but noise. One of the officials exclaimed. He came and went as he will. Scary to think he was able to connect Xian La Palace to somewhere else. Now that he can easily kidnap His Highness who offended him, who knows if he'll just kidnap any other heavenly officials. We can't possibly let this go. We need to stop him right now. If this was the mortal realm, this would be akin to a rebel digging a tunnel beneath the royal palace and sneaking about freely. Of course people were restless. No wonder the middle court officials were busy searching and safeguarding the grounds. Mu Qing, on the other hand, had something else in mind. Hua Cheng has so many devotees and lords over the ghost city. Something minuscule like burning the Paradise Manor is nothing to him. He might not have broken into the heavens just because His Highness offended him. Xi Qingxian immediately countered, "General Zhan Zhen, you're mistaken." Everyone heard Hua Cheng admit it himself. Speaking of, which general is responsible for security this month? that she on La Palace was casted a spell to be connected elsewhere without even noticing. Isn't that a neglect of duty? Pei Ming had been standing quietly on the side, his arms crossed. When he heard Shi Qingxian, he spoke up. Me. Shi Qingxian had accidentally remembered wrong and thought it was Mu Qing on duty, but ended up calling out Pei Ming, and now things got somewhat awkward. However, Pei Ming didn't push off the blame. I'm on duty this month. This is my oversight. Just then, Ling Wen, who was positioned next to the throne, suddenly spoke up. We've news of His Highness Taihua. Jun Wu finally opened his eyes. What did he say? Ling Wen was quiet for a moment, then she replied. He said the Gilded Banquet Massacre had an inside story. He will solve the conflict with His Highness himself, that there's no need for anyone else to interfere. Also that His Highness' request for banishment must not go through. Those are the two things. What inside story? Mu Qing frowned. He didn't say any more. That's all, Ling Wen replied. To see a battle erupt, a hammer smashing down heavily, but landed lightly like feather, the heavenly officials couldn't help but feel rather disappointed. Lang Jianchu was the victim, and the victim was no longer accusing the culprit, so what fun was there to watch? Besides, Lang Jianchu wasn't telling, and Xie Lian didn't look like he was going to say anything either, so there was nothing more to chew on in this matter. Following Ling Wen's report, Jun Wan appointed Feng Xin and Mu Qing to aid Pei Ming in strengthening security and settled a few other matters before waving his hand and dismissed everyone. Xie Lian stayed behind, and he could hear the faint conversations passing by. I knew it. Whenever he stirs up anything, Jun Wu would say he'd interrogate him, but in the end nothing would come of it. We've been blind. He's actually someone significant. Gotta watch what we say from now on. After everyone had left, Xie Lian approached the throne and bowed. I've caused His Majesty problems. This doesn't count as any problems. The real problem was you stubbornly proclaiming yourself the only responsible one of the Gilded Banquet Massacre. Xie Lian was hesitant, but in the end still gave an account of the whole story. After listening to the story, Jun Wu commented. Xian Le, in this matter, you really worked hard for nothing, and pleased no one. Xie Lian lowered his head. I know. Never mind. You're always like this, Jun Wu said. Taihua has now changed focus to pursue the Night Touring Green Lantern. Once he's done so, he will certainly come back for you. Have you thought out how you'll face him? Not yet. But let's think about something else that's more immediate, Xie Lian replied. Jun Wu chuckled. Like what? Is there anything interesting that can amuse me? Was it you who sent the Earth Master to the Ghost City as a spy? Xie Lian asked. Yes, Jun Wu answered leisurely. Why? Jun Wu answered slowly. Because it was Hua Cheng who planted a spy in the heavens first. Xie Lian was taken aback. Jun Wu stood. These past years, news reached Hua Cheng's ears too fast. Some things he shouldn't have known, he knew too well. As for what can be done and what can't be done, where the bottom line is and how to cross said line, he is overly perceptive and precise. That he could connect directly to your Xianle Palace only proves he indeed has a spy here in the heavens, otherwise it couldn't have been done. To be honest, Xie Lian had noticed this too. Hua Cheng really knew way too much, and so to have Jun Wu say it out loud, it wasn't hard to believe. Does His Majesty have any evidence? Xie Lian inquired. Jun Wu shook his head slowly. It's because there's no proof, but things were suspicious that I sent Ming Yi to the Ghost Realm. Who knew that Ming Yi would fall into his hands before the ghost agent was even found? Although you saved him from Hua Cheng's grip, now it will be even more difficult to find that spy. Is it the upper court or the middle court that's the problem? Xie Lian asked. Hard to say, Jun Wu said. Besides you, it could be anyone. Perhaps there's only one mole. Perhaps more. No wonder Jun Wu didn't appoint anyone else to investigate Ming Yi's disappearance. If it could be anyone besides him, Xie Lian couldn't help but think. So even the Wind Master, Qianchu, Feng Xin, and everyone could be a possible agent? Just then, Jun Wu spoke. Xian Le, I know you think highly of Watching right now. You understand your own position, and others shouldn't comment on the friends you make. However, when necessary, be wary of Watching. Don't give anything away. Hearing this, Xie Lian schooled his thoughts. Jun Wu continued, to become a supreme, one must have experienced an unimaginable suffering and pain. One either ascends from such calamities or are doomed to the depths of hell, never to return. The two supreme ghost kings that emerged from Mount Tonglu, Blackwater and Watching, are both far more terrifying than you think. Xie Lian lowered his head, not agreeing nor disagreeing. Jun Wu said, I don't know what his objectives or directives are, but he knows the heavens. That in itself is disadvantageous. When he heard the word disadvantageous, Xie Lian raised his head up and blurted, San Linghe. Seeing that Jun Wu turned his head to him, Xie Lian paused then corrected himself. Watching shouldn't do anything overly malicious. If His Majesty thinks about it, with his strength, should he want to cause havoc and raise hell, he would have done so already. If he didn't before, then without real reason, he wouldn't in the future. I should hope so, Jun Wu said. But you know I cannot be too careful. After leaving the Great Martial Hall, Xie Lian paced slowly down the streets of the Heavenly Court. When he passed by Xian Le Palace, he stopped in his step and looked it over. This was the palace gifted him by Jun Wu. Glamorous, new, but at the same time, foreign. The large crimson-red doors were shiny and bright, but it was already full of nailed-on talisman and charms, forming a giant X, alarming anyone who should see it. When Xi Qingchen exited the Great Martial Hall, he had told Xie Lian that his palace was currently sealed shut since it's connected to elsewhere, so Xie Lian was welcome to rest in his palace instead. However, after staring at this Xian Le Palace for a while, Xie Lian suddenly turned around. He didn't go to the palace of the Wind Master either. He stopped caring for what he was originally going to do and instead headed straight to the Ascension Gates and jumped. Passing through the Sea of Clouds, the point of his landing was Mount Taiking. Upon the summit of this Mount Taiking used to sit the cultivation center of the ancient Xian Le Kingdom, the Holy Royal Pavilion. The Holy Royal Pavilion was an impressively expansive cultivation center. Its Trang grounds and temples covered the entirety of Mount Taiking, worshipping numerous gods and immortals alike, scintillating and glorious. The main god worshipped was the Martial Heavenly Emperor, and its golden temple on the highest peak of the mountain. The temple of the Crown Prince that once stood on the second highest peak also used to be magnificent and grand. 800 years ago, the flaming red maples that covered Mount Taiking was infamous. And within the crimson maples were endless crowds of devotees. However, when the Xian Le Kingdom fell, the crowds of devotees became crowds of angry mobs, scaling the mountain to set ablaze the temple of the Crown Prince, but ended up setting fire to the entire Mount Taiking, burning it down to nothing but blackened earth and ashes. The burnt earth, akin to ground buried with the dead, seemed to become even more fertile. Afterwards, new seeds were planted upon this burnt earth and new trees emerged. A few hundred years later, the mountain was fresh and covered once more, but the red leaves were no longer, and the scenery is very different than 800 years ago. When hiking the mountain in the past, there used to be a wide, paved green path. On the path, one could often see a pilgrim or a young trainee hauling firewood or water. Now, this path was long gone. Rocks and debris, withered branches and sticks had covered its tracks, burying it deep underground. As Xie Lian climbed, he used only the strength of his legs, and when he ran into thorns or bushes, he'd take Feng Xin and cut them down. When he reached halfway up the mountain, Xie Lian felt fatigued and leaned against a dead tree, ready to rest. Suddenly, the black shadow of an object came crashing down from above the branches, making weird crackling sounds as it came rushing towards him. End chapter.